What was that moment like when you got the call that, you were the guy, they wanted you to be the manager of the Mets?
I mean, like I said, and that's the reason I used excited probably 100 times up there, it was the best feeling in the world. And you know what? I'm looking for a great challenge, and this is going to be that challenge, and I'm going to embrace it, and I'm going to do everything I possibly can every single day to accomplish something really special with some really special people.
For Mets fans who might not be too familiar with your style as a coach, how would you describe your coaching style and how you think that will translate now to the manager's role?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's what Sandy said. I just want to be a leader, and I want to care about players. So, you know, no matter what happens, mistakes, wins, losses, I'm going to show them that I care and that I understand that every one of them is an individual and that it's okay to make mistakes. I'm going to make mistakes. They're going to make mistakes. And we're going to learn from it and be a team because of that.
When you look at this current pitching staff here, we've seen what they could do just a couple of years ago. You've been known as a guy that has been able to individually relate to each player and find out what they need to do to get better. How do you now approach this offseason with trying to figure out this pitching staff and how to get each one of them to reach the potential that we saw a couple of years ago?
Yeah, I mean, I think we just need to start establishing a culture that's going to breed that. And no matter, you know, who is talking to a player in this organization, everybody has to be aligned and know what is important. And if you can do that, then nothing's going to be missed. And players are always going to know what to expect, and they're going to go in the right direction because of that.
There's a lot of talk about your relationship with Terry Francona here today, but even as a player, you were around some pretty impressive managers. You were around Mike Socha, you played for Buck Showalter, right? And also your pitching coach a couple of years was Bud Black. What were the things that you were able to take from each one of those guys that you think has molded you into the coach and ultimately manager that you are now?
Yeah, I mean, it's probably the communication would probably be the first thing. The in-game management and how to communicate to players, there's going to be tough decisions that I might make that players are not going to be happy with, but I'm going to make them for the culture and the team and for us to have success. And every player is going to know why I made a decision. I owe that to them every single time I make a decision, and they're going to be on board with it and understand exactly why, because I'm going to, you know, show them.
Mickey, you've talked a lot about the human element, and I think sometimes that gets lost nowadays when people are talking about baseball. So much is about the analytics, the advanced metrics. How do you, as a manager in this day and age, meld the two? How do you not rely too heavily on it, but obviously make sure that you integrate that into your managing style?
Yeah, I mean, I think you have to be a data-driven manager that uses every one of his players' strengths to the max, while always realizing that they are human beings and that mistakes are going to happen. And that even because the analytics say it, we have human beings that are doing it, and it might not turn out to be the right decision, even if it was the perfect data-driven decision. So we're going to care about the players and understand that, hey, it's okay, you booted a ground ball. Let's go get them next time. And everybody's going to have each other's back and care about one another, and we're never, ever going to back down from a challenge.
Mickey, one of the things that was pretty evident when you were the pitching coach in Cleveland was that you like the curveball. There are a lot of curveballs thrown by your pitching staff. Is that something that was more because of the personnel there, or is that something that you want to bring as something that this pitching staff will rely on as well?
I liked their curveballs because their curveballs were nasty. and we told them all along, we have to first and foremost think about our strengths as pitchers. And if we can pitch to our strengths, supplement those strengths and stuff with a game preparation that takes into account what the hitters can and can't do, then we're going to be really good. And that's what they did. And they had nasty curveballs.
You talked to Terry Francona at all about managing in a big market. He was in, obviously, Boston, Philadelphia, managing you here in New York?
I did, and his advice was to be myself, and that's what I'm going to do.
Well, you've done a pretty good job of it so far, and listen, I like the choice of first press conference saying I was named after Mickey Mantle, so I mean, that's a bold choice
yeah,
that you were named after
Yankee. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
But we appreciate the time. Congratulations again, and this is the first of many, so
thanks
he'll get sick of me in about a month or two.
Yeah, appreciate it. Thanks.
You got it.